Hey everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Land 2 for the Bandai Wonderswan. April Fools, it's a Nintendo GameTron. That was a pretty good joke, you guys. Okay, so we just finished the third zone, and we got the third of six golden coins. So we're halfway there, you guys. We have three more zones left, at least I assume so. I only know where two additional zones are. I know where Macro Zone is, and I know where Mario Zone is. And other than that, I don't know where the last golden coin might be. There are definitely secret levels that I missed, and you can tell because there are dots on the map that I have no way to access, and I don't know how to get to those. I'm assuming I would need to go into, to get to those two, I would have to go inside Pumpkin Zone, and there's a secret exit in one of the levels. But this is a blind playthrough, and I don't want to mar the blind experience by using a FAQ, so I guess I'll just miss out on those. I don't know, I might do an extra video after I finish the game where I go back and use a FAQ and try to clean up some of those extra levels just to show off as much of the game as I can. But for the main game, for the main LP, I don't want to do you guys like that. This is the raw, uncut, blind LP Duke of the Bump experience. This is what you guys pay for, and I know this is what you want to see, so... Oh, what? Man, I've never seen an ant grow spikes like that. That is so unrealistic. Super Mario Land 2, if I was reviewing you, you would get a 2 in realism. Out of 10. That's a really bad score. Man, wouldn't it be messed up if review sites... I was about to say magazines, but everyone knows magazines don't exist anymore. The review sites rated games on realism. That would be so dumb. It would be like rating a movie on realism. I mean, you never read a Roger Ebert review and he says... The physics when that car blew up were so unlifelike. Cars don't explode like that. Anyway, this is Macro Zone, and this isn't really what I was expecting. I was kind of expecting, the inside of a house. That's what the overworld view of this zone looked like, anyway. So, I don't know what this is exactly. It looks more like, it looks kind of like Tree Zone, to be honest. There are giant ants everywhere. Nature. I don't know what that... I don't know what that black water, lava, tar substance is down there. I can't tell what it's supposed to be because it's in black and white. I'm assuming it's water, but it's hard to tell. Maybe it looks so... It looks so weird because, you know, I'm shrunk down and that's what water looks like at this microscopic level. Oh, that's a shame. I would kind of like to get in there, but it does not look like it's going to happen. So back we go. So yeah, I guess, I don't know, is this like the front yard or something? And I'm not actually inside the house yet? Whoever lives here has a real ant problem that they should probably deal with. I guess that's why I'm here. I'm like the hired exterminator. Yeah, I can take care of those ants for you. What do I charge? Oh, you know, one golden coin. Which is a pretty reasonable rate in this economy. Oh, I thought I couldn't go in there. That would have been a really weird place to put a pipe. If I was not able to go in. So yeah, I'm having... Aww. Wait. Do all the doors have, like, a star over it like that? Does that signify something special about the exit? Is there... Now I can go back if I want to and check out the other door, but... I guess I'll just go through here and see what happens. I don't remember if the other doors had a star or not. Oh! Well, would you look at that? We found a secret path into the attic. That's kind of cool. I kind of want to go back to that level and see what's through that other pipe. But if this is the secret exit, then it probably wouldn't be anything that spectacular. Maybe like some one-ups or a bunch of coins or something. Well, this is a pretty roundabout way to get into an attic. Oh, I have to be... Oh, wait, never mind. I was going to say I have to be careful with my fireballs here, but that's not that kind of block. Oh, hey. Well, what... Aw, oh, man. I'm never going to be... That was a bad idea. I'm sure there was something awesome down there if I could have done that fast enough, but... Now I'm small and I won't be able to do the spin jump, so... No. Oh, wait. Alright, I'm gonna have to be on this. I'm gonna have to be, like, right up at the edge of the screen so I can, execute the spin jump with a sufficient amount of speed. Man, even still, the screen is scrolling really fast. I don't know if this is gonna be feasible. But, I mean, it has to be. They wouldn't put this here just to torment you, right? Oh, God. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Alright. Coins, just what I wanted. It's like this game read my mind. Okay, well, that wasn't worth losing a life trying to get to, but... I mean, I have 26, I don't need to see. This is the, wait, can I go in here? Oh god. Oh no, 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 no. Come on, come on, come on. Okay. I'm assuming there was something in that question mark block, but I was too panicky to actually get it. Oh, I see. That first level was like a little puddle in the front yard. Okay. Well, that makes sense. It's like a little, like a footprint or something that it rained and the water collected in the indentation. Alright, so we are in the attic. Oh, this is awesome. This is exactly what I wanted this level to be. Mario shrunk down just in a normal, everyday... Whoa! Hey! Come on! That's not cool. Oh, I guess I can't fireball the witch. Okay. Well, whatever. I have 26 of them. You probably need it more than I do. But yes, this is what I wanted this level to be. Although the enemies are just normal size, so I guess it's not like Giant World in Mario 3. It's more like... It reminds me of the library level in Castle of Illusion. Another game that I LP'd quite a long time ago. But that's a pretty good game. If you guys are new to the channel and you haven't watched the Castle of Illusion LP, you should check it out. It's good stuff. But yeah, this level bears more of a resemblance to that than Mario 3. Because in Mario 3, it's just a normal Mario level where the enemies and everything, all the blocks, are way bigger. So yeah, this is more interesting than that, I guess. I mean, I guess it makes sense if Mario shrunk down that everything else would be shrunk down too. Aw, man. I need my fire flower. So, I've been trucking with these LPs lately. It's been fun. I think I found a daily update schedule that worked for me. Well, not daily, but week daily. Oh. So I couldn't even have collected that heart if I wanted to. Well, wait, can I jump on the witch and get it that way? If I couldn't fireball her? Oh, okay. Well, aw, man. Stupid piranha plant. Okay. Need to explore some of these pipes. It looks like there's something up there, because there's like a wall of spikes there. I don't know how to get up there, though. Maybe there's some hidden blocks that I missed. One commenter pointed out that there are hidden blocks everywhere in this game, which I can believe. Yeah, I don't know if there's a way to get up there. I don't know how to get up there, if there is a way to get up there. I mean, I'm assuming there is, because otherwise those spikes wouldn't be there, but... Oh well. Well, I'm kind of running low on time. I'm not sure if the starting time limit was smaller in this level than other levels, but normally you start with like 600 seconds. I wasn't paying attention to the timer at the start of the level. I should be fine though. I'm probably getting pretty close to the end. So yeah, this game is full of secrets, I'm assuming, that I'm not finding. Whoa! This was the boss level? Really? Well, maybe I didn't want to skip here then. But yeah, LP updates every weekday. I'm liking this the schedule. I hope you guys are enjoying it too. I guess that is the boss level. It has the boss symbol on it. Well, that's interesting. But yeah, I'm hoping to keep these going for a while. Obviously, I can't make any promises because I'm not the world's most dependable person, but basically, what I'm doing is I'm just recording a couple episodes at a time, like two or three episodes at a time, and updating five times a week instead of seven. It makes it a lot easier for me to do that. I hope you guys don't feel like that's cheating, me recording multiple videos at a time. But it's just a lot easier for my schedule. See, that's why I liked doing the streams. Because I could do, you know, a 2-hour stream a couple times a week. And that's a lot easier for me to work out. And doing it like this, it's basically the same thing, except that it's not live, obviously. Damn, that needle mouse is tenacious. Alright, Marco. I'm gonna finish your zone. Polo. Hey, we're almost at 1,000 coins. That's kinda cool. I'm looking forward to seeing what happens when I put 999 coins into that crane game. I imagine it'll be something pretty spectacular. See, the joke was that the name Marco looks kind of like the word macro. That was a joke. But then I immediately died, so I wasn't able to play that up as much as I wanted to. This is definitely the hardest boss so far. I've died more times to the needle mouse than anything else. Well, any other boss. Also, I've almost killed 100 enemies, so it'll be interesting to see if anything happens when that counter rolls over. I mean, they're only two digits, so I'm assuming when it hits 100, it'll roll over and something will happen. I'm not sure, though. Fanfare! Alright, well, we finished this stage a little bit prematurely. So, before I go on to, Mario Zone, I'm going to do the couple levels in here that I didn't do previously. Oh, I see. I can't even move on to the next level until I go through the other exit. Okay. Well, I'm sorry this video is going to be a little anticlimactic, well, with me beating the boss in the middle of the video rather than the end, but I wasn't sure. I mean, I should have realized that was going to be the boss level because it had the dot on it, but I wasn't thinking about it, so bonus content, I guess? Don't think I'm going to get 999 coins in this episode, but probably the next episode. Ha, your spikes are no match for my fire. Everyone, I don't know. Yeah, what the heck. So, video games. I haven't really been playing that much other than this recently. I've been playing the Bravely Default demo on the 3DS for a little bit, and, when the enemy counter hits 100, that's what makes that star fall out of the sky. Okay, that must have happened at least once, and I didn't realize it. Well, that's interesting. But yeah, the Bravely Default demo. I like that game a lot. I like the combat a lot, but I've kind of hit a wall. The demo is completely separate from any of the content in the actual game. So it's basically just a bunch of side quests that you can do. And by finishing them, you unlock bonuses that you get if you do buy the actual game, which is kind of cool that stuff carries over. But I'm at what I think is the last boss of the demo. I'm pretty sure it is. And it's kicking my ass, and I'm not really sure... Oh, why did I do that? No! Crap. I actually had a chance to go in here. And I messed it up. I mucked it all up. I'm thinking if I can hit those, I might be able to get hit and then get in there, but it doesn't look like that's possible. Damn it. I'm getting in there. See, I'm acting like I meant to do that when I actually didn't mean to do that. But I was thinking of killing myself so I could go back and see what's in there. But yeah, that game's fun. I'm not sure if I'm going to buy the full game, because... I mean, I guess I just need to grind for a little bit to power up to the level where I can take on the boss of the demo. And I've just been kind of putting that off. But no, it's a cool game. It's the best non-Final Fantasy Final Fantasy game in a while. Alright, note to self, do not jump to the right of this question mark block. Excellent, good job. I'm sure this will be well worth it, whatever's in here. Aw, man! That would have been 3 extra lives, but one of them disappeared when I scrolled off the screen. So, I just got back the 2 lives that I lost. Trying to get in there. Great. Okay, well, now I know. Oh, good lord. This might end up being the longest video yet, even though I killed the boss 10 minutes into it. See, why didn't that disappear when it scrolled off the screen? It was just that one extra life. Weird. So yeah, other than Bravely Default, I have not really been playing much of anything. I've been working a lot, but I can't really complain because my job is not that difficult, and I'm still working a lot fewer hours than like a lot of people work, so it's not really that big of a deal. Let's see if these extra lives respawn. Excellent. I started listening to the Harmontown podcast, the show that Dan Harmon, the writer of Community, has been doing for a couple years now. That is one of the funniest shows I've ever listened to. I mean, it's funnier than most shows I've watched. Like, it's one of the funniest anythings I've ever experienced. If you enjoy comedy, I highly recommend checking out Harmontown. Alright, so I don't want to go up there this time. I want to continue going forward and get the other exit. I mean, I guess, in a way, none of this is actually necessary, since I already got the coin. But since this is an LP, you know, I'm going to show off as much of the game as I can. But yes, Harmontown, check it out. Just Google Harmontown, and it's one of the first results. I really need to start watching Community now. because I've heard a lot of great things about that show. And now that I've discovered Harmontown, and Dan Harmon's involved with most of that show. He was fired for, like, one of the recent seasons, but they hired him back. But one of the reasons, I mean, I heard a lot about Harmontown, too. It's very beloved in the podcast community, but one of the reasons I decided to check it out was because I started watching the show Rick and Morty, and Dan Harmon is involved in that show. He's not like the showrunner, but he has some creative input into the show. And I'm like, damn, this dude's pretty funny. Because that's a really good show, too. It's kind of like a much darker Futurama, sort of. Only not as... Like, Futurama, the world is pretty consistent, and... I mean, it does some crazy stuff. But Rick and Morty tends to go off the rails a lot, which is, you know, it's really great. But yeah, that's what I've been up to. Working, listening to Harmontown, watching Rick and Morty, even though there's only been, like, I think there's been 8 episodes so far. Yeah, that's the Duke of the Bump Media Roundup. Your source for all the great entertainment news and discussion. And this fish is really, really grinding my gears. Okay. See, I wasn't sure if I could actually swim over it. Oh, crap. Alright, come on, extra lives. I'm not gonna get any. Damn it. I probably could have hit that cheap cheap, but I thought my invincibility would have run out sooner than that. Like, the music ended a second before the actual power-up ended. Oh, cool. Another one. I probably could have kept my combo going if I went up there. Just gotten boatloads of extra lives. I almost said extra men, but that's kind of an outdated term. Not very inclusive terminology there, even though Mario is a man, but the phrase extra men, you know, when you're a kid, it tends to be applied to extra lives no matter what the gender of the character is, so trying to be a little more conscious there. I guess I probably shouldn't be hitting those. I don't know what the deal... Wow. I went through puberty there for a second. I don't know what the deal with those enemies that flew away are. Like, I guess if you can actually hit them, maybe they give you something. Oh, hey, it's this one. We haven't gotten this one in a while. Okay, so what do I want? You know, I'm not going to spend too much time obsessing over this. I'm just going to kind of go for it. All right. Okay. Oh, well. That worked out pretty well. I should just go for it more often. Alright, so I'm assuming once I finish this level, it's just going to take me through the fireplace to the attic. And there's not going to be any other reason to go this way. But, you know, gotta be as thorough as possible. So yes, Dungeon Hack still on the docket. Like I said in a previous episode, I'm just waiting for overtime to be over at work, so I have a little bit more time to devote to those episodes. Because even though I'm going to be doing a short game of Dungeon Hack, I'm going to be doing, like, the easiest setting, it's still going to take a pretty long time. That's going to be 10 levels, and the levels in Dungeon Hack are pretty huge. I'm anticipating each episode being, like, at least half an hour, possibly as much as an hour long, depending on how complex the level layouts are and how much stuff there is for me to do. That's a pretty, still going to be a pretty decent size undertaking. I'm looking forward to it, though. I downloaded Dungeon Hack. I installed Dungeon Hack from my CD that I have that has Dungeon Hack on it. You know what? Screw it. That game's so old. I mean, I downloaded it from an abandonware site, so even though it's not technically illegal, I don't think there's anyone that actually cares about the Dungeon Hack IP in 2014. But yeah, I attained Dungeon Hack, and I've been doing a little bit of practicing. I'm not going to do a full game. I don't know, I might. But yeah, that game's still fun. I figured out a way to play the game. You know, I just want to see something real quick. See, I thought there might be something there. So I figured out that Dungeon Hack is a lot more playable if you use a program called AutoHotkey, and you remap the number pad keys to WASD and Q and E, because, you know, I'm right-handed, like all non-sinister people, and trying to play Dungeon Hack with my right hand on the mouse and my left hand on the number pad is a real pain in the ass. So if you use AutoHotkey to remap the keys, then it plays a lot more like a modern game where you would use WASD to move around, and it's a lot more playable that way. So that's one thing I'm gonna have going for me when I do start that LP. If any of you have played Dungeon Hack, I recommend trying it out. It's AutoHotkey is like a really powerful, simple to use program for doing like basic scripting tasks in Windows. I think it's Windows only, so sorry Mac people. But you can use it to you can automate stuff. You can remap keys on your keyboard. You can set up hotkeys to, like, you can set up a script that makes it so whenever you hit control shift N, it opens up Notepad. That's one of the example scripts it gives you, and it's really, really simple to use. The tutorials and stuff are really robust. So yeah, Dungeon Hack, DOSBox, and AutoHotkey makes that a very playable experience. Goal! Kind of a shame that it's a bell and not a pole, because I really like the phrase goal pole. I'm not sure when they started using that phrase, but in one of the newer Super Mario Brothers games, or one of the 3D Land slash World games, I forget which one, but it refers to it as the goal pole. Ah, hell. Oh, wow. It's actually possible to not get anything there. I thought it would always give you something. Okay, well, that has been Macro Zone. Once again, sorry for the anticlimactic fighting the boss in the middle of the video thing. Let's go spend these 1,000 coins. Like, I've had 1,000 coins for a while now, and like the last 200 or so coins I collected have been wasted because I can't hold it anymore. My rupee pouch is not that big. Alright, this better be worth it. That's all I'm going to say. Oh my god, there's a 99 up? Good god. I didn't see what else was on there. There's like a 500 coins thing, I think? That's going really fast. So, let's just hit it and hope for the best. Oh, hell yes. That is amazing. 99 up. Wow. Well, I'm not going to have to worry about getting a game over for quite a while. Well, that's a good place to end the video, since I didn't end it at the boss. 99 up. Wow. It's too bad I didn't have a 3-digit life counter. I would have had like 130 extra lives. Sorry. So yeah, that'll do it. Tune in tomorrow for, I guess, Mario Zone. I don't know where else to go. Hopefully after I finish Mario Zone, something happens that reveals the sixth stage to me. Otherwise, I might have to go digging around for some of those secret levels. And I don't really want to have to do that, because that could be not fun to watch. Two more left. See you guys tomorrow.